Welcome to the session of Master Stroke, and this Master Stroke is related to your DI, data interpretation. And now we are going to discuss about one of the small measurement of the business that is called profit and profitability. But profit and profitability only will drive any of the business, it is going in right direction or not. If you are able to make the money, you are able to make the profit, then you can say your business, your ideas are in good direction. Your ideas are fruitful. But if your profits and profitability are not good, then you can say it is not in good direction. Then this is one of the important parameter. Your business is successful or not successful, that will be measured or based on the profit and profitability. Then of course it is more applicable for your T1 type of DI caselet, because T1 type of DI caselet we will solve all type of business related caselet, and business related caselet profit and profitability always will come in the picture. Then this is going to affect your DILR section together. And just we'll try to understand what are the business terminology or other than profit and profitability are there that may be asked during your exam. And if it is asking, then without panicness, you have to understand how to handle it. Then business related caselet based on the tables and graph are asked very frequently in MBA entrance test. This is very common or very frequent. If you will just see, almost every year or alternate year, based on the business related models or based on the data of business, any particular business or maybe comparison of two businesses, question will be asked or DI caselet will be asked. But few business related terminologies will be used to measure the performance of any business. Just will look few terminologies what are very frequently used. Like one is sales, that is very frequently used. Sales as per volume, sales as per values. Next is revenue. Expenditure, everything you know, no need to explain what is expenditure, what is revenue. I think that was basic level, not required. Capital, expenses, profitability, liabilities. What is liabilities? I think you know. GDP, GNP, gross GDP and GNP, some differences will be there, little bit, not much. This is gross domestic product, this is gross national product, little differences are there. Inflation, liquidity, market share. If you are getting little bit doubt, you can just go through the, you can search on Google also, there is not, because all the knowledge are internet. Then you can just, otherwise if you know little bit about the economics, then almost all the terminology I think you know. If you don't know, just you can check, you will able to differentiate. Don't go in depth, just to try to understand if you are facing 3-4 variable together, then how to differentiate among all the variables. That much only, your goal is that much. You are not going to do PhD in economics here, or your goal is not to understand economics fully. But I used to tell to understand all basic terminology or fundamental terminology related to almost all subject. Here to solve the DI question, economics terminology will be useful or commercial terminology will be useful. But when you are going to round 2 exam like GDPI, WAT, maybe it is related to history, geography or political science or maybe constitution, almost all field, maybe philosophy and psychology, if you know the fundamental or basic terminology, you will feel very much easy to tackle the WAT or round 2. Next is liquidity. After then market share, again so many definitions are there. Market share, overheads, again return, rate of return, CAGR, so many things are there. Here we'll try to understand about two terminology, profit and profitability. Based on that, just I picked one this set of data. This is represented in the form of line graph. This is line graph representing, first graph is sales and second graph is expenses. Sales, it is given in the span of 5 years, 2000 to 2005. Again, expenses also given 2000 to 2005. Both of the data is just given in terms of 100 at a starting. What we have done? We have just indexed both of the value at 100 at a starting of the year, means in 2000. You cannot say like sales also 100 and expenses also 100, but we have indexed at 100, means some variable are there, something is there, common factor where which is multiplied here, all the data of expenses like 100, 120, 160, 210, whatever is there, some common factor is there that is multiplied. Maybe we will take one variable, same way some common factors multiplied all the sales data 100 to 130 or 160 or maybe 200 or 230, whatever we are picked, maybe compared to 100, some common factor will be there that will multiply with all the data. Just we'll take in the form of variable. Here we will take common factor is x, here we will take common factor y. That is very simple, x y. ये तो पीछा छोड़ने वाले नहीं है, बचपन से नहीं छोड़े, पीछा अभी भी नहीं छोड़ेंगे, जब तक मैथ है x y रहेंगे. Then x is a common factor for sales. price y is a common factor for expenses. Then this data you understood, this is given in the form of line diagram 100, 130, 160, 140, 200, 230. Again, 6 data will be given for expenses 100, 120, 160, 210, 190 and 230. Now, both sales and expenses of 2000, year 2000 are indexed to 200. There was a profit in each of the given year. That is important data. Because we don't know about the value of X and Y, we don't know any relation between X and Y, then how to compute the profit, how to measure the profit. Then one of the information is given, every year company is getting the profit, means not a single year sales is less than expenses. What is meaning of profit? Profit is simple meaning sales minus expenses. If it is positive, you are getting profit. If it is negative, you are getting loss. Means sales should be more than expenses. Whatever you are selling, that should be more than your expenses, whatever you are putting for running the business. Then profit will be positive only and only if sales is more than expenses. That only we have to check. And based on that, we will able to compute some relation between X and Y. That is common factor for sales. And Y is the common factor for expenses. Then question is, find least profit. Good question. Good question, we can say. Now, the same data, profit is sales minus expenses. Profitability is by definition, it is profit by sales. The same data we will write in this tabular format, sales, expenses. This is year 2000, 2001, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sales are 100x, here 100y. We have taken because it is indexed to 200. We have taken the common factor x for sales. Means it will become 130x, 160x, 140x, 200x, 230x. Similarly, expenses will become 100, 120y. We can check in table. There is no issue. 100, 120y, 160y, 210y, 190y, 230y. Correct? Now, same thing we'll write here, 100y, 120y, 160y, this. Now, just by seeing itself, where sales minus expenses can be minimum, One thing is there, X and Y we don't know. Then wherever these initial factor, whatever is coefficient is there, coefficient of X in sales and coefficient of Y in expenses, if sales data is more, then we can say it will be always positive. Like here, 100 minus 100, okay, it will be 0. If you are just ignoring X and Y, 130 minus 120, it is plus. Here it is plus, or here again it is 0. Here it is a minus, here it is a again plus, here it is again 0. Means either you are getting the data 0, positive, negative. 0, positive, negative. All three type of data is getting. Where it will be least? Where it is negative. Simple thing. Where it is negative, sales minus expenditure is negative. This 140 minus 210, then X and Y will manage, it will be least profit, or because question is not telling it is loss. Question is telling the condition, it is always a profit. Then this data means 2003 data will give the information about the least profit. For least profit, what can be the relation between X and Y? Then profit here, sales minus expenditure, profit least, minimum sales and maximum expenditure, that is called least profit. Then year 2003, it is 140x is greater than 210y. This is your, in 2003, it is minimum sales, and same way you can say it is 210 maximum expenditure. Then based on that, just we will find the condition X is greater than 1.5y. Means minimum X should be equal to 1.5y. To make this statement valid, every year this product or this company is getting the profit. To make this statement valid, X should be minimum 1.5y. If any value you are taking the Y, just suppose you are taking the Y equal to 5, then X minimum will become 7.5. More than that is possible. More than that, it will increase the profit, but minimum it should be there. Otherwise, in 2003, company will get the loss. And question is telling, company is not in loss a single year. Every year, company is getting the profit. Maybe marginal profit or maybe zero. That also we can say it is not a loss. If X is having the minimum value, then which year profit will be highest? Now this is another question. Just you can say extension of question. Difference between sales and expenses maximum. This is 2001 and 2004. Between 0 and 4, 0-4 will be higher value. We can just check here. For 2001, it is given 130x minus 120y. if you are putting x equal to 1.5y, it will come 195y minus 120y, it is 75y. For 2004, it will become 200x minus 190y. X equal to 1.5y, it will become 300y minus 100y, it will become 110y. Irrespective of value of y, in 2004, it will become maximum because you got the maximum coefficient, maximum value of coefficient of y, it is 110. Y may be 5, 4, 1 or 2. Always in 2004, you will get the maximum or highest value of profit. Highest value of profit you will get in 2004. When it was the minimum profit? Minimum profit was in 2003. Least profit you got in 2003 and maximum or highest profit you got in 2004. If this type of very beautiful or good level of question and caselet you want to understand further to further level related to T1 type of caselet or maybe T2 type of caselet or all any type of DI caselet, how to solve very beautifully with the use of Vedic Math tools, then just continue to learn at the rate of paroliko.com or you can download the app also. Thank you.